Hello, I'm Dr. Marie Comer, PhD in linguistics, and currently participating in a research project on communications for Renaissance Fusion. It's Friday, 19th of March, and this is your Fusion News Update. Stories today include 1. MIT energy startup homes in on Fusion, with plans for a 47-acre site in Devens. 2. Bottling the world's coldest plasma to unlock the secrets of fusion power. 3. Fusion thruster company wants NASA to go to Mars with nuclear propulsion. 4. New analysis promises accelerated development of fusion power. Plus a few bonus topics in the end to discussing the future of fusion energy.
1. MIT energy startup homes in on fusion, with plans for a 47-acre site in Devens. MIT fusion startup Commonwealth Fusion Systems recently announced that it will build a new campus on a 47-acre site in Devens, Massachusetts, not far from its current base in Cambridge. Daniel Clurie also writes in a feature for Science magazine that Commonwealth Fusion Systems has settled on its key technology, a timetable, and now also a site for its compact, affordable reactor. Construction of the new campus is slated to begin this spring, and CFS, as it is known, would move there as soon as late 2022. The new campus in Devens will be home to the startup's compact fusion device, dubbed Spark, based on a combination of proven plasma physics and high-temperature superconducting magnets. Devens will also be home to the company's headquarters, an advanced manufacturing facility, as well as a 150,000 square foot research center that would double the company's workforce from 150 people today to 300 by 2025. This campus will be the site where we harness fusion and prove it can work as a clean, limitless power source for the first time in history, said CFS CEO Bob Mumgard. CFS hopes to complete construction of Spark in 2025. 2. Bottling the world's coldest plasma to unlock the secrets of fusion power.
Physicists from Rice University have discovered a way to trap the world's coldest plasma in a magnetic bottle, a technological achievement that could advance research into clean energy, space weather, and astrophysics. Generally speaking, it takes extremely hot temperatures for plasma to form, like those found in the sun or in a lightning strike. Scientists at Rice University have been exploring how a technique known as laser cooling, developed in the 1990s to slow atoms down almost to a halt, can be used to create low-temperature, low-density plasma and to study how it behaves in the lab. Holding the plasma in place for long enough for fusion reactions to occur, or understanding the reasons why it doesn't, is key to the pursuit of clean nuclear fusion energy. Co-author Stefan Bradshaw explains, "As soon as there's a small sort of perturbation in the magnetic field, it grows and the nuclear reaction is ruined. For it to work well, you have to keep things really, really stable. Looking at things in a really nice, pristine laboratory, plasma could help us better understand how particles interact with the field."
3. Fusion thruster company wants NASA to go to Mars with nuclear propulsion. A radiation detection company called US Nuclear Corp has urged NASA to sign a contract to develop a nuclear fusion-powered spacecraft propulsion system capable of transporting humans from the Earth to Mars.
US Nuclear Corp works with magneto-inertial fusion technologies, or MIFT, which spun out of UC Irvine, with an emphasis on developing a thermonuclear fusion-based generator. They want to help NASA ferry the first crewed flight to the Red Planet as soon as the early 2030s.
The fusion power generator that MIFT is developing might offer 10 million times the energy per payload of typical chemical rocket fuel. The generator could also reduce a one-way trip to the Red Planet to only 3 months. The article goes on to explain why fusion reactor propulsion could be the next step for space exploration. And the outlet, Interesting Engineering, also has an article about direct fusion drives as a form of propulsion. We will put the link in the description below. 4. New analysis promises accelerated development of fusion power. A new analysis of experimental data from Princeton Plasma Physics Laboratory and Cullum Center for Fusion Energy demonstrates that spherical tokamaks can have an efficiency 10 times higher than conventional tokamaks such as jet or ITER. A new paper by Alan Costley and Stephen McNamara of Tokamak Energy, published in Plasma Physics and Controlled Fusion, shows for the first time how this difference impacts performance under reactor conditions. High efficiency is an essential requirement for making electricity from compact, relatively inexpensive fusion power plants. And now, here are some bonus articles. First, there are several more articles in local press about various locations in Britain looking to host the STEP pilot plant. More details on this story are to be found in the Fusion News from 19th of February. Second, JT60SA successfully reaches its full design toroidal field. The JT60 website has some news and pictures of its toroidal field coils, which have been successfully tested at a maximum current of 25,700A. JT60SA, short for Japan Torus 60, is a joint international fusion experiment that has been designed to support the operation of ITER. And finally, there's an article in Raconteur on fusion, mostly discussing the UK's publicly funded efforts with UK EAE CEO Ian Chapman, but with a mention of private company First Light Fusion too. So that's all for fusion this week. Please like and subscribe for more fusion news and check out the links in the description below if you want further information.